Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to the channel. Going to be starting a new series today with Fallout 3. Really looking forward to playing this game. I played about halfway through it and quit playing for some reason. So I decided to go back to it because I don't really have nothing else to do. Destiny, everything just went wrong with that. I've been having a heck of a lot of problems. I feel like I say that every single time I make a video, that I'm always having problems with something. Whether it be my power cord on the Xbox going out, or just having a lot of problems with my computer and having to redo Windows constantly. Just nothing ever goes right, and hopefully all this crap can be fixed later. But yeah, let's go ahead and get started, guys.
I don't want to set the world on fire. I just want to start a flame in your heart. In my heart I have but one desire, and that one is you. No other will do. I've lost all ambition for worldly acclaim. I just want to be the one you love. And with your admission that you feel the same, I'll have reached the goal I'm dreaming of.
War. War never changes. Since the dawn of humankind, when our ancestors first discovered the killing power of rock and bone, blood has been spilled in the name of everything from God to justice to simple psychotic rage. In the year 2077, after millennia of armed conflict, the destructive nature of man could sustain itself no longer. The world was plunged into an abyss of nuclear fire and radiation. But it was not, as some had predicted, the end of the world. Instead, the apocalypse was simply the prologue to another bloody chapter of human history. For man had succeeded in destroying the world, but war never changes. In the early days, thousands were spared the horrors of the Holocaust by taking refuge in enormous underground shelters known as vaults. But when they emerged, they had only the hell of the wastes to greet them. All except those in Vault 101. For on that fateful day, when fire rained from the sky, the giant steel door of Vault 101 slid closed and never reopened. It was here you were born. It is here you will die. Because in Vault 101, no one ever enters, and no one ever leaves.
Meow.
Let's see. Are you a boy or a girl? It's a boy. A boy. We've got a son, Catherine. A beautiful, healthy baby boy.
Oh, James. We did it. A son. Our beautiful son.
You've got a bright future ahead of you, son. I'm sure of it. Look at you. Look at you. Hi there. I'm your daddy, little guy. Daddy. You're going to need a name, aren't you? Your mother and I have been talking. What do you think about...
I just go ahead and use my actual name. I don't know if I don't even know if you really even know what my name is. I don't think I've ever actually said. Well, there you go. Now you know my name.
That's a good name, don't you think? Fits you perfectly. Looks like they've finished the gene projection. Let's see what you'll look like when you're all grown up.
What the heck? Oh, yeah, there we go. I'll be Elvis. Let's go with random. What's the deal? Why won't the hair change with random? I'm just gonna go with this. I don't really care. It doesn't really matter to me. Facial hair. There, yeah, sure. I don't really care. Oh, good lord. Let's go with that. Yeah, we'll just stick with this, I don't really care.
You're going to look a lot like your dad. See that,
Catherine? I don't think so.
Oh, very strapping.
It's a big world out there, son, full of all sorts of people. What about you? What kind of person are you going to be?
You're James? Just a...
Catherine?
James?
Catherine! She's in cardiac arrest. Start compressions. Get the baby out of here. Move! Move! 1,000. 2,000. Come on. Hang on, Catherine. Hang on. Okay?
We need a doctor, not a deadbeat. This one's on the house. Fail to meet my expectations now, and there will be no repercussions.
James and his cheery charity.
Decorations.
May your future be bright.
Don't look straight into the light, pal. Just like home. It'll hurt your eyes. It's just something you get used to down here. Come on over here, son. Come on. Walk to daddy.
Oh, that's weird.
There you go. My goodness. Just a year old and already walking like a pro. Your mother would have been so proud. Listen, kiddo, I know you don't like it when Daddy leaves you alone, but I need you to take care of yourself for a minute. You just stay here while Daddy runs to his office. You'll be okay, pal. I'll be back in a bit.
So, guys, this video is going to be a little bit longer. Really? Was that easy? What else are
they? Dada.
Okay, so... I'll cut this out. I doubt you really care about this. Okay, guys, this is what I decided to go with. I didn't really know exactly what to do. Because they all seem like pretty good, except for perception. This game's kind of stupid, but oh well. What else? I just did.
Dada.
What else do I do now? Oh.
You are quite the little explorer, aren't you?
Serves me right for trying to pin you in. Come on over here. I want to show you something. See that? It was your mother's favorite passage. It's from the Bible. Revelation 21:6. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. I will give unto him that is athirst of the fountain of the water of life freely. She always loved that. All right, come on. Let's go see if your little friend Amata wants to play.
Who just walks off and expects their one-year-old to follow them? Must be a very smart one-year-old.
Experiment.
Don't be a damn fool.
We experiment to prepare. We prepare to survive. Of course I miss her. I miss her so.
Surprise! Stanley, you turned the lights on too fast. You blinded the poor kid.
Happy birthday!
Happy birthday!
Can you believe it? He is growing up so fast.
Happy birthday, pal. I can't believe you're already 10. I'm so proud of you. If only your mother...
Congratulations, young man. I don't have to tell you how special this day is, do I? Down here in Vault 101, when you turn 10, well, you're ready to take on your first official Vault responsibilities. So here you are. As Overseer, I hereby present to you your very own Pip-Boy 3000. Get used to it. You'll be getting your first work assignment tomorrow.
Enjoy your party. You're only 10 once, so have fun.
Happy birthday! We really surprised you, didn't we? Your dad was afraid you were onto us. But I told him not to worry. You're so easy to fool. You're welcome. But really, your dad did most of it. I just helped with the decorations and stuff. Hey, I bet you can't guess what I got you for your birthday. Go on, guess.
I'm gonna try to be a nice guy.
I knew I surprised you. Who's your favorite barbarian? That's right, Grognak. Issue 14. And with no missing pages. I found this in a box of my father's old things. Believe it or not. Imagine him reading comic books. I guess everybody was 10 once. Well, I better let you get back to mingling with your guests. We'll talk later, okay? Happy birthday.
Don't talk to everybody.
Oh man.
Happy birthday, Sonny.
I wish I was 10.
Where people must be. Like, it's been like a year since I played, so I don't remember all the little buttons and stuff.
Hey, thanks for inviting me. Really cool party and everything. I know that, Butch and I give you a hard time, but you don't take that seriously, right? Anyway, happy birthday and everything. I better get back to, you know.
What, are you two best friends now? Hey, Wally, I think Paul's gone soft on you.
I hope you appreciate the effort Amata put into this party. She really seems to like you, for some reason.
That's not nice.
Don't presume too much on her friendship, young man. I'm still the Overseer, and I'm still in charge of this vault and everyone in it.
Somebody's a little power-happy.
Happy birthday. Are you having a nice party? 10 years old. My, my, my. Seems like only yesterday that your daddy came. Goodness, listen to me ramble. You're waiting for your present, aren't you? Fiddlesticks. What 10-year-old doesn't like presents? I was 10 once, believe it or not. My goodness, the vault was practically crowded back then. Not like today. So few young people now. But here I am rambling on again, and you listening so politely. Here you go. A nice sweet roll that I baked for you just this morning. And it's all for you. No sharing required today.
You introduce
Attention
us to your
everyone.
New best friend.
It's time to pop
you
the cake.
Cold face here?
Andy, great face.
Oh,
hey!
No.
Nice party.
Did
Didn't I tell you to stop
good
bothering
one, Butch.
Us?
Button.
Shut up!
I wanted to offer you a piece of cake, Mother.
Daddy, I told you not to act all official.
I'm hungry, and that stupid robot destroyed the cake. Give me that sweet roll you got from Old Lady Palmer.
Dang, so mean. I don't really know this pit. Gotta go to your mom
joke.
Don't
talk about my mom, you little punk.
I know you were joking, sorry, but I'm not sure anyone else did.
Nonsense. Whoa. People always enjoy my
Should
visits.
Have just given me the sweet.
Besides, that friend of yours could
Butch,
use a
what do you think you're doing? Leave him
what
alone.
What is that? Fun and game. One of the 3,000 A models? What piece of
happy
junk?
Happy birthday.
I think you have to
you all right, son? Have good ideas.
Too many people talking at the same time.
Yeah, I got one. The Mackers.
How's it going?
What's Butch's problem, anyway? I can't believe he tried to start a fight at your own birthday party. What a jerk. God, he really is a butthead. Oh well, you can always count on Butch to make an ass of himself. Get it?
Well, super cool, right?
Are you all right? Is Butch giving you a hard time again? I'm glad to hear it. Once you start letting bullies push you around, you'll never see the end of it. Come on now. I bet there's someone else out there with a present for you.
Enjoy
it's just so many things.
How do you like that Pip-Boy, son? Fit all right and everything? As a matter of fact, I did. I'm glad you like it. Some may think the A-Series is a bit basic, but I've always preferred them for their reliability. Don't mention it. Oh, yes, I almost forgot. Happy birthday. Not much, but I hope you like it.
Wait,
do you think we surprised
so,
him?
What do you think we should call
baseball
him?
Sure of it, Amanda.
Totally
never suspected
him.
A thing.
Now, what will I do now?
I am.
Who wants to go around all day being called a vote willer? Don't say I think you really are as dumb as you look.
How are you enjoying the party,
okay.
Mrs. Palmer?
I think I've talked to everybody. I don't know what else to do now.
What are you looking at?
Oh, really? They're lovely. You did such a splendid job.
Jonas?
Are you having
hey,
a
Doc.
Nice time?
We're all set down here.
Thanks. I'll send
Hello,
him right
Mr.
down.
Gomez?
Hey, that was Jonas on the intercom. He and I have been cooking up a little surprise present. Jonas is waiting for you downstairs on the reactor level. Go ahead. I don't think anyone will mind if you slip out for a few minutes.
I'm glad you can make it.
I'm glad to be here. I think it's important to keep in touch with the young people, you know, as part of my job.
Reactor.
Happy birthday, dearie. My goodness, I hope I didn't miss the party. They sure did. My, my. 10 years old already? Why, I can remember helping your dad change your diapers. And now look at you, a great big grown-up 10-year-old with your very own Pip-Boy. Since this was such a special occasion, do you know what I did? I wrote you a poem, just for you. I hope you like it.
Yay.
Of course. Run along.
You could be a spoiled little kid if you want to.
Have yourself a wonderful birthday.
A swell. I like it.
This way.
What are you doing down here, young man? I thought kids weren't allowed down on the reactor level. Oh, I see. Now that you're 10, you're all business. Well then, mister, we'd better get to it. Happy birthday, by the way. Hang on one more minute. I think I hear someone coming.
Are you ready for your surprise? The Overseer gave you your Pip-Boy, and you're old enough to do some work, so I figure you're old enough for this. Your own BB gun. It's a little old, but it should work perfectly. Jonas found it down here. It was in pretty rough shape. Took us a good 3 months to find the parts to get it working again. You know how tough it is to find a spring that small? Good thing Butch misplaced that switchblade of his. So, what do you think? Want to give it a try? Easy now. It's only a BB gun, but it's not a toy. Let's go try it out. Jonas and I have found a nice spot for you. Follow me.
I feel like when there is dialogue in this game, it's going to be a lot. The thing is, I really like Bethesda, I think that's how you pronounce it. I really like their games they make, like, you know, Skyrim and everything is great, so. More than likely, though, this is going to be a very long series.
You can come down here and shoot anytime you want. Couldn't have done it without Jonas's help. You make sure to thank him.
So, how do I do this? It's not very accurate.
Careful, it's a rad roach. Think you can take care of that with your BB gun? Just aim and shoot. You'll be fine.
Who's that? God, it's most unaccurate thing.
Good work. That's one less rad roach to deal with. Let's get a picture together. Capture the moment. Hey, Jonas. Get a picture of
that's something you hate about this game. Hunter. I hate roaches. I absolutely hate roaches.
Smile.
Boys and girls have different parts.
What is her problem anyway? So I'm the Overseer's daughter. So what? That like I get any kind of special treatment.
Revelation 21:6. I am Alpha and Omega. The beginning. And the end. As far as I can tell, you're a perfectly healthy 16-year-old boy. So yes, you have to go to class to take your goat exam. Go on now. You've got a goat to take. The Generalized Occupational Aptitude Test. Goat. Everyone here in the vault takes it when they're 16. Helps to figure out what sort of a job you'll have here in Vault 101 when you get a bit older. So, pay attention and try not to fall asleep. You know what the Overseer says? We're born in the Vault, we die in the Vault. Each is tested to determine their abilities, that they may work for the betterment of all Vault residents. Huh. Sound familiar? Hey, it's not my call. Those are the rules. You're 16 now, so this year you take the goat. Come on, it's not so bad. Everyone has to take it. You'll do just fine. Take care, son. I got out of here, and good luck.
Well, so now I'm just as tall, I'm taller.
Hey, 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 sport. It's been a while since you stopped in here to see us.
Get out of my way, you stupid tunnel snakes!
Don't mess with the tunnel snakes. What? You mouthing off, Spaz? Everyone knows the tunnel snakes. We rule this vault, and we don't take shit from nobody. Not you, not her, and not her daddy, the overseer. Stay out of this. It's tunnel snake business. Me and Butch were just having some fun with this chick. I don't follow anyone. Wally Mack is his own man, and the tunnel snakes is where I belong. Why? You think Butch is in charge? Is that what people are saying? Because it's a load of shit if that's what they're saying. What? What kind of shit is that? No one talks that way about Wally Mack. He's not the boss of me. Nobody's the boss of me. I'm out of here. We're done.
Sorry, here. I realized I was going a little too fast.
We're not done. I say when we're done.
Don't know who put you in charge. I say we're done. Let's go, Paul.
Are you sure? Butch? Okay. Whatever you say, Wally. Tunnel snakes rule. Fine, let's go. I was done here anyway. This ain't over, Daddy's girl. I'm not finished with you either, twerp.
Thank God that's over. Thanks for getting rid of them. Assholes. I don't know why they won't leave me alone. Just because my father's the overseer, I guess? Idiots.
Yeah, I realized I was going a little too fast, and y'all probably couldn't read what I was saying.
Well, I guess you got the gist. All set for the goat? Trust me, it really isn't that bad. Just something everybody has to go through. I'm sure you will, especially since it's multiple choice with no wrong answers. We'll start as soon as everyone's found a seat. Good luck.
Be the scholar and sit in the front seat. I don't know if I could be extra seat anywhere else.
Well, now that everyone has managed to find the classroom, we can finally get started. No talking, and keep your eyes to yourselves. Yes, I'm talking to you, Mr. Deloria. Unless anyone else has an insightful comment, let's get started. Question one. A frenzied vault scientist runs up to you and yells, I'm going to put my quantum harmonizer in your photonic resonation chamber. What's your response?
What is that ticking noise?
Question two. While working as an intern in the clinic, a patient with a strange infection in his foot stumbles through the door. The infection is spreading at an alarming rate, but the doctor has stepped out for a while. What do you do?
She picked that one.
Question three. You discover a young boy lost in the lower levels of the vault. He's hungry and frightened, but also appears to be in possession of stolen property. What do you do?
This is mean choices.
Question four. Congratulations. You've made one of the Vault 101 baseball teams. Which position do you prefer?
Soccer. I hate baseball, actually, so I should pick that. I'm going to.
Question five. Your grandmother invites you to tea, but you're surprised when she gives you a pistol and orders you to kill another vault resident. What do you do? Question six.
I love the answers.
Old Mr. Abernathy has locked himself in his quarters again, and you've been ordered to get him out. How do you proceed?
swear.
Question 7. Oh no, you've been exposed to radiation, and a mutated hand has grown out of your stomach. What's the best course of treatment?
Pull up to the brain.
Question 8. A fellow Vault 101 resident is in possession of a Grognak the Barbarian comic book, issue number 1. You want it. What's the best way to obtain it?
I'm gonna go with the
question 9. You decide it would be fun to play a prank on your father. You enter his private restroom when no one is looking and... Question 10. Who is indisputably the most important person in Vault 101? He who shelters us from the harshness of the atomic wasteland, and to whom we owe everything we have, including our lives.
Okay. This guy's a little power hungry. Is there an option E?
Pencils down, people. That's it. The infamous goat. I'm sure most of you didn't find it so bad. Others, well, there are always openings in the maintenance department. Don't forget to hand in your test before you leave. You don't want to know what happens to people who fail the goat. You can have the rest of the day off. Celebrate. Or to pray, as the situation warrants.
Sorry about the little ticking thing. It was this thing making the noise. It was annoying. Or this thing. But it was a game, so nothing I can really do about it.
Here you are, Mr. Brotch. I hope I did okay.
Nothing for you to worry about, Miss Almodovar. Let's see. Very well done. Looks like it's the supervisory track for you.
Thanks. See you tomorrow.
I don't really see how those answers tell you what you're going to do the rest of your life, but okay.
I admit that I've been waiting for this day for a long, long time. Allow me to savor the moment. Now then, let's see. Really? Interesting. You surprised me, Butch. I didn't think you had it in you. Hairdresser. Who would have thunk it?
You're so full of it. That isn't true.
All finished?
I'm all done, Mr. Brotch. I guess. Wait a second. Can I have it back? I think I need to change one of my answers.
Just calm down a minute, Paul. I'm sure you have nothing to worry about. Let's see. Yep, just as I thought. You're slated for the engineering track. Congratulations, Mr. Hannon. You've passed the goat.
Oh, gee. That's not so bad. Engineering, all right. Snake life forever.
Well, well. Pip-Boy programmer, eh? Stanley will finally have someone to talk shop with. Yes, it's refreshing to see such, youthful enthusiasm. Good to know that the goat occasionally gets it right. You know what they say about monkeys and typewriters. Well, I'm glad things turned out so well for you. I hope your classmates find their results half as satisfying.
Huh. Boy, my gun suck. I mean, I can't reset it. I don't know if I want to, though. We'll take on arm. We'll go small guns, because, I mean, I don't know. It's so hard. I feel like Snake's very important thing in this game. So, yeah, we'll do it.
Hello.
Now what? Exit the classroom.
I'll see you tomorrow, bright and early.
Anything is possible, even an A.
That is Mr. Brock. He's safe now.
Is he?
Selfish and insubordinate.
Look, just like
you need to know this.
Wake up! Come on, wake up!
I'm going to be around to hold your hand forever.
Come on! You've got to wake up! You've got to get out of here! Your dad is gone, and my father's men are looking for you! He's left the vault! I don't know how, but he's gone, and my father, he's kind of gone crazy. It's Jonas! They killed him! My father's men! They took him and... Oh my god, you have to leave now! Yeah, don't worry about me. I'm just sorry you had to find out like this. I know Jonas was your friend. But we've got to go now. My father's men will be here any minute. Not anymore, apparently. But are you honestly telling me you had no idea your dad was leaving? He really didn't tell you? Oh, I'm sorry. I'm sure he had his reasons. Maybe Jonas was supposed to explain everything to you? But it doesn't matter. I can help you escape. I have my own plan. Listen, there's a secret tunnel that leads directly from my father's office to the exit. You'll have to hack the computer in his office to open it. Use these to get into his office. That's how I always get in. Oh, one more thing. I stole my father's pistol. I hope you won't need it, but you'd better take it just in case. Okay, I'll try to meet you at the exit. Watch out for security. Good luck!
Okay, guys, I think I'm gonna end the video there. It's getting kind of long. I really hope you're going to enjoy the series. Say, this game's supposed to be really good, so... Yeah, guys, I'm gonna stop here, and I will see you next time.